This is Asghar Gauri. This video is an extension to my other YouTube video, group account and group password files in Linux, in which I provided an overview of Linux groups and presented an analysis of the group and gshadow files, which store group account information. In this video, I will share my knowledge with you on creating and managing group accounts using a few commands that I highlighted in that other video. For demonstration, I'll use my CentOS 7 system. However, the commands and procedures I'll share apply to other popular Linux distributions and their spin-offs as well, with the exception of some possible differences in command names or command options. Also, for this demonstration, I have pre-created four user accounts, user 1, user 2, user 3, and user 4 on this system. And here's what I'll be covering in the next few minutes. Number 1, create a group account with the group add command. Number 2, add members to a group with usermod and gpasswd commands. Number 3, add group administrators with the gpasswd command. Number 4, assign a group password with the gpasswd command. Number 5, use the new grp command to change the group temporarily. Number 6, modify a group with the groupmod command. And number 7, delete a group with the groupdel command. The group add command is responsible for group account creation. This command has a few options available to override its default behavior. However, only two of them are more common. The first one is the -g option, which is used to specify a numeric GID of our choice. And the second one is the -o option that we can use to assign a GID which is already in use of some other existing group. Check out the manual pages of the group add command for more details and other available options. Let's create a group called DBA. Sudo group add dba. Group created, simple command, no options used. And let's check the entries added to the group and the gshadow files. Sudo grep dba /etc/group/etc/gshadow files. And here is what it shows. The group file, dba group name, 1004 is the GID, and in the gshadow file, group name, no members. Now let's add user 2 as a member to the DBA group. For this purpose, we can use either the usermod command or the gpasswd command. Let's try usermod first. Sudo usermod -a to add a member, uppercase G to add user 2 to the DBA group as a secondary group member. And there you go. Let's verify it again. Use the sudo grep dba. As you can see, user 2 is a member of the DBA group. User 2 is a member of the DBA group. The GID is 1004. Now let's use the gpasswd command and add user 3 to the DBA group. Sudo gpasswd -a to add user 3 to the DBA group. And let's check the group and the gshadow files and see what information it has now. So the DBA group has two members, user 2 and user 3, and they are comma separated, user 2 and user 3. Next, I'll add user 1 as a group administrator for the DBA group so that this user can add or delete members going forward. Sudo gpasswd -a to add user 1 to the DBA group as a group administrator. And here is what the files contain. In the gshadow file, as you can see, this is the group. User 1 is the administrator, and user 2 and user 3 are regular members in this group. Let's assign a password to the DBA group for non-members. Here we go. Sudo gpasswd dba, and the password, a simple password, and password has been assigned. Let's check the contents of the gshadow file, and as you can see on the screen, this is the encrypted password for the DBA group. User 1 is the administrator, user 2 and user 3 are regular members. Now, as user 1, I'll switch my primary group to the group DBA using the new grp command. I'll enter the group password when prompted. Well, I first wanted to show you what is my group membership at the moment. So I run the groups command and it shows that the only group I am a member of is user one. So new GRP, DBA, password and groups. Now my primary group is a DBA group. I will now add user 4 as a regular member of the DBA group. GPass WD minus A user 4 and the group name. Adding user 4 to group DBA. So as an administrator of the DBA group, user 1 was able to add a user to the DBA group. And here we go. Sudo grep DBA from the group and the gshadow files. User 2, user 3, and user 4 are regular members of the group now, and user 1 is the administrator. Now, as a regular member of the DBA group, I'll try using the new GRP command as user 2 and see whether it prompts for the group level password. So let me first switch my ID into user 2. And now try this command, new GRP DBA. Let me show you what group membership I currently have. User 2 is my primary group and the DBA group is my secondary group. And now I'm going to run the new GRP command DBA. It should not prompt me for the password because I am a member of the group. And there you go. I run the groups command again. And my primary group has been changed to the DBA group temporarily. If I press the Control D combination, I will switch back. I also have a user account called user 5 on the system. Let me switch into user 5 and try to use the new GRP command to change my primary group to the DBA group and see what happens. su-user5. User 5 does not exist. Let me just quickly create it. User add user 5. Done. And su-user5, I have to assign a password. User 5, su-user5, password, I'm now user 5, and the only group I'm a member of is user 5. User 5 is not a member of the DBA group, so this user should be prompted for a password. So let me enter some random password. Invalid password, and I am still user 5 group. So user 5 can only switch to the specified group if user 5 knows the group password. This restriction does not apply to group members, user 2, user 3, and user 4. Now I want to demonstrate the use of the group mod command to modify the group name and group GID for the DBA group. Sudo group mod minus G. Let's change the GID to 3201 and let's change the name of the group to DBA1. DBA. I can try as user 5. Sudo group mod minus G 3201 minus N DBA1 new group name for the existing group DBA. And there you go. Sudo grep DBA1 from the group file and from the gshadow files. And as you can see in the output here, DBA1 is the new group name, 3201 is the new GID. User 2, user 3, and user 4 are still the members of the DBA1 group. Now, deleting a group is a simple task. Simply run the group del command and specify the name of the group that you want to erase. Sudo group del DBA1, the group has been deleted and we can verify with this command again. And as you can see, there is nothing in the group or gshadow file that matches the name DBA1. And this brings us to the end of this video. Try the examples I've presented on your Linux systems. For additional information, don't forget to check out the manual pages of the group add command, the group mod command, the group del, gpasswd, new GRP, and user mod commands. And here is a list of all the free videos on Linux that I have created for you. These videos complement my books on Linux to understand Linux from scratch to an advanced level and at the same time help you get ready for Linux certification exams such as RHCSA, RHCE, CompTIA Linux Plus, LPIC1, LFCS and LFCE. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up, provide your comments below and share it with your friends and colleagues. Please subscribe to my channel to be among the first to get notifications of my new videos. Thank you for your time.